Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am sitting with my good friend Victoria. We're gonna talk about some really cool things, but first I'm gonna have Victoria introduce herself and we'll get the conversation started.
My name is Victoria. I go by other names. I don't know if I should share those.
Yes! What are these names?
My other name, my radio show name, Cleo Jones. And my other name that nobody really knows, but I like it, Makeda Kravitz.
Ooh. Okay.
I don't think you heard it.
No, I haven't. I knew Cleo Jones. Yeah, and Cleo Jones. Love it. So Victoria, like what do you do and what are you into?
I do a lot. That's what I do. Of course I work with art, but then the things that I love to do, that I would like to do for the rest of my life, I usually geared towards music or film, stuff of that nature. So I co-host Rawthentic on KHX with DJ Needles, and I also have Black Cinema Club in Link Space monthly. You know, even though, yeah, I love my job, but, you know, being able to do the things that I love in addition to, it's always, you know, it's always pure energy that goes into it.
So what? What is this that we have here? Let's talk about this.
This is a lot of my life right now. This is just a small fraction of my vinyl collection.
I've seen part of your collection, and yeah. They're like literal crates.
Yeah, I have like, well, that's the good thing. My collection is actually small compared to a lot of people, but this is like basically the stuff that I sifted through and was like, yeah. I love this. I love this person. I love this particular album. Or this is my favorite. So the sequence at the police, of course, Stevie.
Oh yes.
Which of course brings me to my favorite
album. Yeah, there's some more of these. Oh, you had it at the bottom for
it. It was at the very bottom. Mama's Gun.
Oh my goodness.
This is my favorite album of all time. Period. It is everything.
Oh my goodness. Yes. I've never seen like the vinyl side of this.
It's something spiritual about it that makes me love it so much.
Why music? Like, what was it for you that got you into music and also film?
Music probably was the start of everything else in my life when it came to art, period. Mm-hmm. Especially because music, it brought me to like different ideas. It was very imaginative. Sometimes and they have these stories in their songs that are just like, you're imagining these things falling into place. It's helpful for kids to hear this stuff because it allows them to be creative. It allows them to like visualize what they're hearing. Mm-hmm. Growing up, I had a good backing of variety of music because my father was that guy who listened to like Keshi.
Oh my God.
He was the Keshi guy, but he also loved like A Tribe Called Quest. Mm-hmm. So it was like he was a very diverse taste in music.
Right.
My mother was the same way, but she was way more like into like the soul and the like mainstream like type of music. So I got a good balance of what I typically wouldn't hear in a black household, mm-hmm. in addition to like, you know, what I probably would hear in any other household.
Right. And so for yourself, do you create music as well? Like, do you sing, do you play, or anything like that? No?
Nothing. I was in church choir when I was younger. And
so
I was
you can hold
I can sing, for the most part. I wouldn't call myself a singer, but like I can sing for the most part. I can carry a tune if needed. I'm a curator of music.
Curation.
That's what I would go for. I'm more of like, I like to put things together, like something that somebody's already created, just put it together. Mm-hmm. I used to make mixtapes when I was in high school.
Yes, yes.
I would, like, if I heard music on the radio, if I was just like, you know, looking up stuff, mm-hmm. I would go, what was the website? God, one of those pirated websites.
Yes.
I used to do it. Go look up those songs, get all the viruses in the world, but I would have the best 15 track mixtape ever. Uh-huh. And people would, like, some people used to ask me my stuff, I was like,
this is a slinger. So with being someone who curates music, do you feel like it's allowed you to become also a historian of sorts? Like, do you bridge those connections between what was happening in music and when certain albums were produced and like what was happening in culture and history and all of that.
Yeah, that's the thing about music. It's not just something for the time, but it is something for the future. And it's about having something that is reflective of the time period in which you are, just like any other art form should be. It should be reflective of the time in which it is created.
Mm-hmm. So let's transition. Mm. Womanhood. Womanhood and music. When you put those two words together, what are some of the things you think about? Like for yourself or in the industry at large?
It's not even about music making me feel anything as a woman, as a black woman. Mm-hmm. It's just making me feel human. And it's about making me be able to connect with people that I probably wouldn't be able to like access easily. For me, I've been privileged to work with people, especially DJ Needles, who is very, you know, well-rounded and open to, you know, all experiences, especially experience of a woman and a black woman. Mm-hmm. But women in music, they still have a hard time. They still have to figure out how to, you know, not lose themselves or to make money. But sometimes they have to fit a standard. And and that's the problem. There's always a standard for women. But men tend to have kind of go at it attitude. Like they can do what they want and hopefully at some point it will change. But luckily we have women like Erykah Badu, who is herself. And then we have like Carole King, mm-hmm. and Joni Mitchell. All these women who have, you know, made a way for women who don't want to stick to the standard. But it's sad that it's only a few of them that get past the gate. They only get to that platform once in a while, but not often enough.
I'm going to do a quick, rapid question. Now, I want you to think about the songs that you listen to for certain emotions. Where you're sad.
Orange Moon. Mm-hmm.
Cleaning Your Place on Saturday mornings.
It's jazz. Max Roach.
When you're feeling black girl magic.
Something Beyonce, probably. Any strong black woman will get me to that point. King. That's what I've been listening to a lot lately.
Really?
King. I love them. If you have not heard of King, please look them up. King is a group out of LA, I believe. They're from Cali. And they're three females. They're all musicians. They're all singers. Like, you don't understand how much that like warms my heart.
They're
amazing. And like the satisfaction.
Yes.
Those, again, back to that black girl magic. Those are the women who like
getting ready to go out.
Ooh, K-Trinata. Kachinada is a producer, and he does a lot. His style is very unique. It goes like it's not really set to one standard for me, at least. I've listened to different types of styles from him, but yeah, Kachinada, he has like those moments where he has like the house beats, and usually I don't hear house beats at like the club, so it's like I can get ready to this and like get pumped up and then go and listen to whatever's gonna be played.
Thanks. Any final words that you want to make to whoever is watching this?
My last words would probably be stay open. Stay open to all styles of art and all styles of people. Art is life. Life is art. And it comes in many forms. So from music to film to visual, embrace it. Open up to it and be as loving and endearing about it as possible.
One, thank you, Victoria, for being a part of this.
Thanks for having me.
And as always, and thank you all for watching. Be sure to check out all of the other videos in this series. Like this video, subscribe for more, and stay tuned for some other videos that are coming up very soon. Thank you. How can people contact?
On Instagram, I'm at Cleo Jones. On Twitter, I'm Black Girl Lost. Snapchat, Makeda Kravitz. Facebook, Victoria Bam, BAMN.